Please put your hands together for Mr. Mike Birbiglia, everybody.
How are ya? Nice to see ya. John got my last name right. It's Birbiglia. Everyone gets it wrong. When telemarketers call, they'll be like, "Good afternoon, may I speak with Mr.?" Oh, man. Gabigaboo. So I just have to spell it on the phone like it's B as in boy, I-R, B again, I-G-L-I-A. I wish my last name were just boy. I'd be like, it's B as in boy, and then the rest of the word, boy. I'm Italian. My family's not real Italian. We're like Olive Garden Italian. Sometimes people come up to me, they'll be like, in Italy, it's pronounced Birbiglia. I'm like, in America, you're annoying. It's a hard name to have growing up, though. Kids would call me names like Birbiglebug and Birbibliography and faggot. I was an altar boy when I was a kid, and the answer is no, I wasn't. And I think it's because they knew I was a talker. And also, I was so bad at it, I think they thought, well, if he's this bad at lighting candles... very ambitious as a child. I wanted to be a comedian or a rapper or the owner of a pizza restaurant where third graders could hang out. Those are my goals. And it surprises people that I want to be a comedian because I'm just very awkward in my life. I have a habit of making awkward situations even more awkward. Like, I was moving a new bed into my apartment recently, and this woman who lived in the building opened the front door for me with her key, and she goes, "I'm not worried because a rapist wouldn't have a bed like that." Now, what I should have said was nothing. What I did say was, "You'd be surprised." And there's nothing you can say after that. You're just like, "Oh, whatever. See you around the building," you know, that kind of thing. It's hard not to end up in awkward conversations because every topic is off limits. Like, you can't talk about movies anymore. Like, I was talking to this girl, and I was like, "I hated that movie." And then she was like, "That movie was the reason I stopped cutting myself." And then I had to pull it back. I'm like, "It was pretty good. I liked the ending when she didn't cut herself. I thought that was redemptive."